Welcome students. In previous class, we have seen how to determine the diameter of the bolts if the applied load is parallel to the axis of the bolts. In this class, we will see how to determine the diameter of the bolts if loading is perpendicular to the axis of the bolt. Let us go to the next problem, which says a bracket is fixed to the support by means of three bolts as shown in the figure. The ultimate stress is 380 MPa. If factor of safety is 2.5, determine the size of the bolts. Now, as you can see in the figure, there is a bracket which is mounted to a wall by means of the bolts. Here, the direction of the load is perpendicular to the axis of the bolts. Before solving this problem, let us understand the effect of the load on this type of joints. Consider a bracket mounted to a wall by means of the bolt system as shown in the figure. If you carefully look at the load, this load W will try to shear off the bolts, that is these bolts, the bolts which are mounted on the wall will experience a shearing effect. Now you can see the initial position of bolt was this, and after shearing the bolt position was like this in the bracket. Hence we can say the primary effect of the load is shearing on the bolts. Also, this load W will tend to rotate the entire assembly in this clockwise direction. Now, because of this rotation, there will be some effect on the bolts, and that is known as the secondary effect. In this case, as you can see, because of this rotation or the secondary effect, the bolts are getting elongated in this direction. Hence, we can say the tensile load is being experienced by the bolts. So, the secondary effect of the load is tensile. So, in the case where the load is perpendicular to the axis of bolt, we can say the primary effect is shearing, whereas the secondary effect is being tensile. Now, coming back to our problem, the first step in the problem is to determine the primary effect of the loads. So, step one, primary effect. So, we know that primary effect will be same on each bolt. So, I will write P1 dash is equal to P2 dash equal to P3 dash, as there are three number of bolts, will be equal to the total load divided by number of bolts. So, I will get the share on each bolt is 2500 Newton. In previous cases, we have kept this load as it is, because in the first case, both the primary and secondary effect were shear. In second case, both primary and secondary were tensile. But in this case, one is shear and another is tensile. Hence, we will convert this load in terms of stresses. So, we know that the primary effect is shear. So, I will convert it into shear effect or shear stress as T is equal to we have P upon area. So I will write the first stress is equal to P, that is 2500 divided by area. Let this be equation 1. After finding the primary effect, next step or step 2 is to find out secondary effect. So from previous lectures we know that P 1 double dash will be equal to C into L 1. Similarly, P 2 double dash will be C into L 2, and P 3 double dash will be equal to C into L 3. So aim is to find out now C, L 1, L 2 and L 3. For finding out C, we can write C is equal to P into E divided by L 1 square plus L 2 square plus L 3 square. Now, where E is the eccentricity, which means how much amount we have shifted the load from its original position. So to find that, we need to see what is the point of rotation in this type of load. This load of 7500 will also tend to rotate this joint or this assembly in clockwise direction about this point. Hence, we can say our point or reference will be this, from which I will be measuring all the distances. So E says it's the distance between the point of application of load to the point of rotation. So it is given in the question that distance from this point to this point is 250. So our E becomes 250. Now regarding L1, L2 and L3. These are the distances from the reference point to that particular bolt. So from this point to bolt number 1, the distance is 25 mm. Hence I can write L1 is equal to 25. Similarly, from this reference point to this center line of the bolt is 175 plus 25, that is 200. Hence I can write L2 and L3 both are 200. On substituting the values, we will get C is equal to 7500 multiplied by 250 divided by L1 is 25 plus L2 200 plus L3 200. On solving this, I will get C is equal to 23.255 Newton per meter. After finding C, next step is to find out the secondary effect of forces. I will get P1 double dash equal to 23.25 multiplied by L1, that is 25, which is equal to 581.395 Newton. And similarly, P2 double dash is equal to P3 double dash will be equal to 23.25 multiplied by 200, that is 4651.16 Newtons. So from the above two values, the maximum values on acting on bolt 2 and 3, that is 4651.16 Newton. Hence I will write P double dash maximum is equal to 4651.16 Newtons. We have also discussed that the secondary effect will be tensile in nature. Hence I will write sigma t is equal to P double dash maximum divided by area, which I will get 4651.16 divided by A. Now our primary effect is shear and secondary effect is tensile. So we need to find out what is the resultant stress acting on the bolt, and for that I will use maximum shear stress theory. So by maximum shear stress theory, we have tau max is equal to half root of sigma square plus 4 tau square. So from that I will get it's equal to half square root of sigma, we got as 4651.16 divided by a the whole square plus 4 times tau we got earlier as 2500 divided by a the whole square. On solving this, I will get tau max is equal to 3414.42 divided by area. In the question, we are given with sigma ut, that is ultimate stress, as 380 newton per mm square. So finding out sigma allowable, which will be equal to 380 divided by Fs, which is given as 2.5, which will come out to be 152 newton per mm square. And hence I will find out tau allowable is equal to 0.5 times sigma allowable, which is 76 newton per mm square. Now equating this tau allowable with tau max, so I will get therefore 76 is equal to 3414.42 divided by area, I can write down pi by 4 dc square. So I will get solving dc is equal to 7.5632 mm. Now by looking into the standard of PSG, near to this value I will get my standard bolt size as M10. This completes the solution.